Having a faster, wider aperture lens means you can get some great depth in your photos and videos, but there's a problem using this lens at its widest aperture. Let's talk about it. The 50mm f1.8 is a great lens to get into photography and learn about shallow depth of field. It's budget friendly, you can pick one up under $150 to add to your kit. My first tip is to bump your aperture up to a higher setting for best focus. Then you won't get that chromatic aberration on the edges of the details in your shots. While this lens can shoot up to that very narrow 1.8 setting, you may get some chromatic aberration in the edges and the details in your photos. You'll probably notice this most when you have a bright background and a darker subject that you are shooting. To eliminate this, since this lens shoots at such a shallow depth of field, you can bump that aperture up to 2.0 or to 2.8. You'll still get great bokeh blur in your foreground and background, and the edge of the details, as you'll see if you zoom in on pictures, the edges won't have that purple, hazy looking edge in them, and your subject will be so much sharper. Any lens that you use will actually take the best photos in the middle of that aperture range. If you use anywhere from f8 to f14, you'll get really sharp images out of your lens. F8 is a common use setting for getting very sharp photos. It'll make most of your image to be in focus. You may have heard F8 and be there. It was a saying for photographers to be in the moment and capture their surroundings without worrying too much about their camera settings or their techniques. It meant to be in the moment with the gear that you had, so you wouldn't miss the shot. Using F8 is probably the easiest way to capture crisp, clear, and perfect photographs for most any situation. All that to say, using the mid-range of your lens will give you the best photos. So if we open our aperture up all the way, then we're at the edge of its limit. So by bumping it up just a little bit, you'll get a better photo. It's not to say you still can't use the widest aperture that your lens has. I use the widest aperture all the time. You obviously bought it to use that wide aperture, but in some instances, I may need to bump it up a little bit. So by all means, keep using it. But if you notice those purple edges in your photos, that chromatic aberration, then just close your aperture down a little bit and you'll get some great photos. The cool thing is, having such a wide aperture lens, you can shoot at 2.0 or 2.8 and you still get great foreground, background blur, and it's gonna look great in your images. Still having that great depth of field that you're looking for. With any lens, don't just use the lens for its widest aperture all the time. Use the whole range of that lens for some variation when taking photos and videos, and see what you can get. I hope this video was helpful for you guys. Thanks for hanging out with me. Be sure to subscribe and check out this video next to learn more about this lens. And I'll see you guys there.